This is chapter 7, putting it all together. There's going to be an outline posted for you guys to look at. The first example on here says the drug oxycodone is used to treat pain, but is dangerous because it's addictive and can be lethal. In clinical trials, 227 subjects were treated with oxycodone, and 52 of them developed nausea, based on data from Purdue. A says construct a 95% confidence interval, estimating the percentage of oxycodone users who developed nausea. So in order to do this, we need to create a 95% confidence interval. We need to use, because we're talking about percentage, those are the same thing as proportions, we need to use 1 prop z int on our calculator. And 1 prop z int is going to ask you guys for a few things. It's going to ask you guys for x. It's asking you guys for n, along with a confidence level. So our x value that we have and our n value, n is how many subjects that we had in our study, and the number of subjects that we had was 227. And it says that 52 of them had nausea. So go ahead and take a second to input all that in. We're going to round 3 decimal places. Our interval is going to go from 0.174 to 0.284. Another way to write this, and first of all, does it estimate the percentage? So we can write this with our values on the sides. I am going to move it to percents. Only do this if it asks you guys to, which this one does. And 28.4%. Part B says compare the test results from part A to the 95% confidence interval for 5 subjects who developed nausea. So for this one, I'm going to go ahead and we'll just cross this one off for right now. That's not anything that you would see on your exam, so we won't stress about it. Example 2 says samples of DNA are collected and the 4 DNA bases A, G, C, and T are coded as 1, 2, 3, 4 respectively in the results are listed below. Construct a 95% confidence interval to estimate the mean. So we are dealing with the mean this time. We're going to take all these numbers, have to get inputted in an L1. And we are dealing with the mean. You either use the T interval or the Z interval. We will be using the T interval because we do not know the population standard deviation, which is also known as sigma. So this would involve us to find T interval. And with T interval, you need to make sure that you go to list. You put your numbers in L1. If you put it in somewhere else, then make sure you put that down. Your frequencies will be set to 1. And then your confidence level for this one is 0.95. So go ahead and do that. Your values are 1.831, 3.669. Again, another way to write this, because we are talking about the mean, is between 1.831 and 3.369. The practical use of this confidence interval, there isn't anything saying that the mean values are between these because this actually codes to letters. Again, not very relevant for you guys, but calculating that mean, definitely that confidence interval will be. So the next example says an urban economist wishes to estimate the proportion of Americans who own their homes. What size sample should be obtained if he wishes to estimate the estimate to be within 0.02 with 90% confidence? So he says, what is the size of the sample? That means that we are looking for n. You have a total of 3 equations in chapter 7 that talk about finding the sample size. This one is talking about the proportion, so we are dealing with P. So if you find those in your notes, you have 2 different formulas. One uses a prior estimate, which is like what part A does. It says he uses a 2010 estimate of 0.669 obtained from the U.S. Census Bureau. And then part B is the other one where he does not use any prior estimate or no prior knowledge is known. So from here, I'm going to go ahead and copy down the formulas that we have. And we'll go ahead and fill in everything that we know. Again, formulas are n equals z alpha over 2 squared, and then p hat, q hat, all over e squared. And if you do not know any prior estimate, it's z alpha over 2 squared times 0.25 all over e squared. So figuring out what these values are, your p hat value is given as 0.669. And your q hat is found by doing 1 minus your p hat value. And z alpha over 2, you need to look on page 2 of your chapter 7 notes. And since we are dealing with 90% confidence, we have z alpha over 2 is 1.645 squared, p is 0.669, q hat is 1 minus p hat, and then divided by e, which is our margin of error, which it says within 0.02 squared. Likewise, for part B, it's the same z alpha over 2 value times 0.25 divided by 0.02 squared. Working out A, we get 1,498.01. And with these, you always need to round up. So we will round up to 1,499. We'll say subjects or people. And for our second one, working this one out for part B, you get 1,691.26, which again, we always need to round up. And when we round up, you get 1,692 subjects.